Hello, I am Jamie Gable, and I am a second-year MPH student in the Department of Epidemiology here at the University of Nebraska Medical Center. And my study was esophageal cancer distribution and possible clustering in Kilimanjaro, Tanzania. A little bit of background about esophageal cancer. It is the eighth most common cancer in the world, and it is the cancer with the sixth highest mortality rate. 80% of this cancer cases occur in developing countries like Tanzania. Symptoms for esophageal cancer are non-specific, such as vomiting, weight loss, and dysphagia, which is difficulty swallowing. And this often starts with difficulty swallowing solid foods and then progresses on to liquids as well, so there's complete loss of swallowing. And because the symptoms for this are non-specific, people wait to seek out a doctor, and cases are diagnosed at a later stage. And later stage are treated with radiation and chemotherapy. Ocean Road Cancer Institute, which is what is pictured here, is the only hospital in Tanzania that offers radiation and chemotherapy. The clinicians at Ocean Road noticed a disproportional number of cases coming from the Kilimanjaro region in Tanzania, which is the purple one in the northeast. Methods for my study. This is the records room at Ocean Road. I don't know how well you can see this photo from where you are, but it looks pretty intense when you first get there. It is more organized than it looks. There is a sense of organization there. You just have to dig in and get used to it once you get there. So I looked through patient records for esophageal cases for 2006 through 2013. This starts by going through the logbooks for those years and finding the cases that are esophageal cancer. And then after recording the record numbers for those cases, you go through the records, which was the room I just showed you, and find the cases from the logbooks. And then after that, you abstract the information from the records. The information abstracted was age, sex, residence, smoking status, alcohol consumption, histopathologic type, treatment received, date of diagnosis, place of diagnosis, and the date that began treatment at Ocean Road. The records are in English, so that helps out a lot, and they also, most of the time, this information is available in them, although the histopathologic type is not as often found for records after 2011. The analysis for this project is currently in progress. We are working on receiving data from Kilimanjaro Christian Medical Center in Moshi, and once we get that, we can make sure we have all of the cases from the Kilimanjaro region in our database. We're going to find the age-specific incidence rates for each region, sex-specific incidence rates, number of cases for each age group in a year, and the incidence in a given year for all of the regions. This is the beginning of my analysis. And for each region, we're finding the number of cases that I collected and the population, and then we're going to find the incidence. This is still in progress because the censuses don't have projected populations for each year, so I am working on projecting the populations for the years I collected by using the 2002 census from Tanzania. Preliminarily right now, we are seeing what appears to possibly be a higher incidence in the Kilimanjaro region, but this is possibly deceiving because we aren't getting every single case that comes in. Every case doesn't end up at Ocean Road, so I can't collect data from it. Some cases will die before they go to the hospital, and other cases may not travel that far of a distance, so we might not get every case that we need to get, so we might not see completely accurate data for the region. Some challenges from the study. I don't know how well you can see these pictures either, but these records, they come in all shapes and forms, and sometimes they are eaten by bugs, like these ones are. Other challenges are ethical clearance at Kilimanjaro Christian Medical Center. We're still working on getting all of the data from there. Incomplete and inconsistent records. Not every clinician records data the same quality of data or the same wording and such, and damaged records. Learning experience. Through this experience, I have learned about epidemiologic study design, data collection, medical record abstraction, working with foreign collaborators, conducting a study in a clinical setting, culture of a developing country, which you learn not only just about the culture, but you learn how that affects the healthcare and what that makes you need to think about when you are conducting your study. Application of epidemiological study in a developing country and learning the field epidemiology, putting what I've learned from Dr. Solomon's cancer epidemiology classes into practice, basically. I'm still working on learning more about data analysis and analyzing my incomplete data and then manuscript writing. Here are some photos from while we were in Tanzania. This is Dr. Solomon and Dr. Chamberlain and Dr. Meza with us at Ocean Road, and then this is Kathleen and I with Dr. Muslagi. Some future directions for this research include exploring risk factors that are causing differences in the rates between Kilimanjaro and Dar es Salaam and the other regions, exploring opportunities for esophageal cancer interventions after we find out more about the risk factors, and then looking for differences in other regions besides Kilimanjaro. We're starting to see other regions that might also possibly have clustering as well. I would specifically like to thank Dr. Solomon and Dr. Chamberlain, of course, from UNMC, and then Dr. Kahesa, Dr. Musalagi, and Dr. Nagoma from Ocean Road, and then Melanie Wells, too.
Thank you, Jamie. Questions for Jamie?
Oh, I'm sorry. I meant it the other way. From the cases before 2011, you don't get very good pathology.
Other questions? Could you show the map again where you showed the rates and distribution? So what we see now is this study started because the clinicians observed some clustering of cases of esophageal cancer in Kilimanjaro coming to Ocean Road. So they wanted to know if this is really a high rate of esophageal cancer in Kilimanjaro or not. What we see here is high rates in this region, the whole region, not just Kilimanjaro, but the districts here. NCI has a study on esophageal cancer because they see high rates in Kenya. So it could be this region of Kenya and Tanzania, not just Kilimanjaro and not just Tanzania. The border here is artificial, but it could be some exposure and something going on here in this region. And this is something that we're gonna check on and see where in Kenya exactly and how this could be Tanzania and Kenya in adjacent regions. Not just, you talked about the deceiving rates. Mm-hmm. The deceiving rates could be underestimation. What you see mm-hmm. is actually underestimation of the actual rates because cases don't come to the cancer center mm-hmm. or die before coming to the cancer hospital. Other questions?
Just a comment. The record room she showed is really challenging.
You have to give her credit for
digging. That's what I'm saying. She did a tremendous good job on that part.
She was assertive enough and aggressive enough to dig into these records.